Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. In today's video, I will show you an employee onboarding checklist. I'll show you one that is designed in Canva, and I'll show you the other one that's designed in Google Docs. These two programs are available for free. All you need is a free account to design something like this in Canva. And of course, Google Docs is available for free. All you need is a Google account. All right, so here we're in my Canva account. And this is what I started out with, a very boring generic table of an employee onboarding checklist. And this is what I turned it into in Canva. To do this, first I changed the color of the background, and then I added a rectangle to create this border effect around it. I edited the table by adding some color, and I changed the thickness of the border. And I added some bullets around the questions just to make it pop out a little bit more. Added some color around the status and added the circles that can be checked off as each task is completed. And of course, made the notes section wider. I also added more information here. So new hire name, the position, the department, and the start date. For this multicolored version, I will detach the background so you can see what it looks like. This is a multicolored image available in the Canva library. Once you pull that into your design, all you need to do is to right click on it, set it as image background. Here we have this template without the colors. In order to add some more colors to this table, first select the top row, hit on color, scroll all the way down until you see photo colors. Now I'm going to select the pink option for the first row. Click on this column, select it from the top to the bottom. Go back to colors, and now I'm going to use this orange color here. You can change this to whatever colors you want. This way you have the colors that's in the table matching the background. And the last section, of course, is to create a professional, easy to print black and white option. And of course, all you need to do is change the colors around. After you complete your design in Canva, you do have to download this as a PDF form to use it. To do this, go ahead and click on Share, Download, change this from PNG to PDF. If you're going to be printing it out, this works better than this option. If you're going to be using it electronically, then the first option is fine. And then click on Download. Moving on to Google Docs, we have the same template here. We created a table, we added some color to it, and we added checkboxes here. One of the pros of using Google Docs instead of something like Canva is that you can actually use this form in Google Docs without having to download it as a PDF. So what do I mean by that? Because these boxes are active, you can actually check them off. Fill out your employee information here. Go ahead and share this document with them. They can check it off. You can check it off. You can add notes. They can add notes, and everyone can keep track of the same document at the same time. This is not something you can currently do in Canva. The next template we have here, the checkboxes are right next to the task. So that way you can check it off. And when you check it off, it crosses off that option. This is just a style different. It does the same thing. And just like the other option, this can all be done in Google Docs. If you want to print it out and use it as a PDF, you have the option to do so. But you can easily do all of this electronically without having to print anything out. All right, here is the third option. And for this option, we're using drop-down tabs. We have everything else just like before. We have the checkboxes here. And we have the option of changing the status. So instead of having a done or not done, you can have a completed, in progress, or pending. To do this, all you have to do is click on insert, click on dropdown, and create a new dropdown. There you can add the title of your dropdown and add the different options. You can change the colors here by clicking on the color and choosing the colors that you want. So I'm going to cancel this because I already have my drop-down tabs created here. This third option would be perfect for sharing this document and using it completely electronic. Tell me in the comment section below, which of these options do you like? Would you prefer to use Canva, and use it as a PDF document for Google Docs, which gives you the option to print it out or use it electronically. And if you do decide to use Google Docs, which of these three documents is your favorite? Leave your responses in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.